Welcome to Getting Started with the DevExpress ASP.NET Chart. The DevExpress ASP.NET Chart Control offers a comprehensive collection of 2D and 3D charts to meet the data visualization needs of your end users. In this video, I'll show you how to create a bar chart control, bind the chart series to data, customize the chart using the designer, and add a navigation bar to print and export the chart. First, I'll cover a few of the chart's visual elements. A chart's most fundamental element is the data point. A group of data points represents a single series. Points reside in the series.points collection, and no series is displayed until it has at least one data point specified. Each data point must have one argument and at least one value that corresponds to it. In general, the pairing of an argument and its value is represented on a diagram's axes as their x and y coordinates respectively, as illustrated in the following image. The ASP.NET chart control supports numerous series view types, which represent and organize data in different ways. The visual representation of a data point differs from one view to another. Okay, with that, let's get started. I'll create a new ASP.NET project. I'll select the DevExpress template gallery from the Visual Studio project templates list. Let's name the project and click Create. In the gallery, select ASP.NET, then Responsive Web Application. Let's click Run Wizard. The DevExpress ASP.NET project wizard helps you to customize project settings for themes, localization, and more. Once I click Create Project, the wizard will generate a ready-made web application with DevExpress ASP.NET controls. Now let me show you how to add the DevExpress ASP.NET chart control to a new page. Right-click on the project from the Solution Explorer. Select Add, then select Web Form with Master Page. Set the name to Chart and the Master Page file to root.master. The page has several empty content sections, including head, left panel, right panel, and the main page. I'll add a new chart control to the main page content area. You can add controls from the design or source view. I'll stay in the source view. Later in the video, I'll show you how you can customize the chart using HTML and JavaScript from the source view. Now find the DevExpress chart control in the toolbox and double-click to add the web chart control onto the form. Next, I'll add a data source using SQL Server and the Northwind database. Click the chart's Smart tag to bring up its tasks list. Then open the drop-down list for the Choose Data Source item and click New Data Source. This will invoke the Data Source Configuration Wizard. Choose SQL Database and click OK. On the next page, click New Connection and enter the database details. I'll connect to my local SQL Express instance and choose the Northwind database. Then click Next to save the connection. From the list of tables, choose Products. Click Next, test the query, and click Finish. The data source object is now assigned to the chart. Next, we'll choose which data fields to use to provide data for the chart's series. To do this, click the chart smart tag again and select Run Designer. This brings up the chart designer, which allows you to create and customize a web chart. The chart designer is organized into three main areas: chart elements tree, chart control appearance, and customization tabs. The data tab shows the available fields from our data source. Now, let's add a new series to the chart and bind it to the data fields. In the chart elements tree, expand the series collection element. Now select a series view. There are many types to choose from, including bar, Gantt, polar, and more. Select bar. Now from the data tab, drag and drop the fields to specify our series data members. Select the product name data field for argument, which will be used for the x-axis. Then select the unit price for value, which will be used for the y-axis. Most charts use two axes, the axis of arguments, x-axis, and the axis of values, y-axis. Next, I'll filter the displayed data points in the series. To do this, switch to the Properties tab and click the ellipsis on the Filter Criteria property. Using the Filter UI Editor, create a new condition and set the category ID equal to 4. This filter will display only the items belonging to the Dairy Products category. Now I'll go to the Options tab and enable the Labels Visibility property. I'll change the bars on this view so each bar is colored individually. Switch to the Properties tab, expand the View property, and enable the Color Each property. Click OK to close the designer. I'll run this in the browser. The default size of the chart is too small to display our data points in view, so I'll go back to Visual Studio and increase the size of the chart. I just used our chart designer to show you how easy it is to set up some properties. However, you can also set up the chart in Source View or using the Visual Studio Properties pane. I'll use this to set the size. The height will be 675 pixels and the width will be 1200 pixels. Now, I'll run this in the browser again. As you can see, a stunning data-bound chart can be created with ease. Your end users can use the hot tracking feature to view chart details. However, the end user can't navigate to this chart page since there is no option in the top menu. This can be easily addressed in the DevExpress project template. Go to the Solution view, and in the App Data folder, open the Application Menu Data Source file. Add a new sitemap node item. Set the URL to chart.aspx and the title to chart. End users can now navigate to the chart page and other pages of the web app. Now let me show you how to customize the legend element of our bar chart. From the Smart Tag, open the designer again. To customize the legend for the series, click the Properties tab and then click the ellipsis on the Legend Text Pattern property. From the Pattern Editor, select Argument, click OK. This will allow the legend to display the product names. Since each bar has a different color, I'll remove the labels on the X-axis by clicking the primary X-axis from the element tree and unselect the visibility checkbox. I'll also add a title to the Y-axis to help the users. Click Primary Y-axis and from the Options tab, check the title visibility checkbox. Set the text to unit price dollars. I'll also set the series label. From the Options tab, click the ellipsis for the text pattern. From the Format dropdown, I see there are many choices available on how to change the display format for this text. I'll select value. And after the V, I'll add C for currency. The text will display with a dollar sign and two decimal values. Now, I'll improve the legend positioning on the chart by moving it to the bottom of the chart to allow more room to display the bars horizontally. To do this, select the default legend from the Elements tree. In the Properties tab, set the Alignment Horizontal property to center. Then set the Alignment Vertical property to Bottom Outside and the Direction property to Left to Right. The chart designer shows us the preview without running the app. Finally, I'll add a title to the chart and set its text property to Product Prices Comparison. Let's run this in the browser. Now our chart has a title and an improved legend. Now let me show you how to add printing and exporting functionality. Above the grid view is a toolbar with buttons to interact with the grid view. There's a similar toolbar area on the chart page. I'll add a button there to print the chart. In the page toolbar area, I'll add a simple HTML button and set its height to 50 pixels. As you can see, the button can function, but it doesn't have the same theme and styles of the existing UI. Instead, I'll use the left area and another DevExpress control for a better overall user interface. As you can see, there is a content section labeled Left Panel Content. I'll add a DevExpress ASP.NET navigation bar control there. Find the ASPX nav bar in the toolbox and drag and drop it in the left panel content section. Open the designer from the Smart tag. I'll create a new group and set the text to Output. I'll set the item image position to top so the nav bar displays a separator between each item. And I'll expand the item style and set the horizontal align property to center. Next, I'll add a new child item, set the text property to print, and the name to nbprint. I'll select the group and add another child item, set the text property to export and the name to nbexport. Now let me show you how to easily set an image icon without adding images to the project. Click and select the print item. The DevExpress ASP.NET subscription includes an icon collection. The easiest way to assign an icon is to use the Design Time Icon Picker dialog. Expand the image property. Click the Icon ID Properties ellipsis button to display the Icon Picker, which allows you to access images from the gallery and assign them to specific control elements. The Item Picker includes search and filtering features to locate images. In the search field, enter print, and from the search results, I'll select the printer icon with a green checkmark. I'll also select the larger 32 by 32 image size. Once an icon is selected, a string identifier is assigned to the icon ID property. Now I'll also select an image for the export navbar item. In the search field, enter export. I intend to export using the PDF format with this navbar item, so I'll choose the icon with the PDF label. Click the client-side events link. You can use the client-side item click event to invoke printing and exporting. You can configure the JavaScript client-side code through this designer. However, I'll use the source view to show a different way to set up the code. I'll add a short comment as a placeholder and click OK. By adding the comment, the designer has generated the client-side events HTML section with the outline for the item click event. I'll set the width to 100% and run this in the browser. Now the end users have an improved UI with the navbar. This plain button is now unnecessary, so I'll remove it from the toolbar area. Now I'll show you how to write the JavaScript code and print the chart. As I mentioned earlier, you can invoke both the print and export functions of the chart from the client side. To enable client-side functionality of DevExpress ASP.NET Web Forms controls, use the Client Instance Name property. This property specifies a unique client-side identifier for a DevExpress ASP.NET control and enables the client-side API. For the chart, set the client instance name to chart. For the navbar, set the client instance name to navbar. Now in the item click event, I'll verify which navbar item was clicked by checking the e.item.name property. Then call the chart's client-side print method. Now in the browser, click the print button and the browser's print dialog is displayed. However, the chart is too large for this layout, so let me show you the methods to fix this issue. I'll create a variable called options to retrieve the chart's getPrintOptions. Then I'll set the options.setLandscape property to true. And I'll call the optionsSetSizeMode method and pass in the stretch argument parameter. Using this argument, a chart is stretched or shrunk to fit the page on which it's printed. In the browser, click print again. And voila, the page has a landscape layout and the chart has been stretched to fit the page. Next, let me show you how to export the chart. The code to export is nearly the same as printing, so I'll copy and paste the code. Then change the second if statement to check if the nbexport button was clicked. Then call the chart's save to window method. I'll pass in the PDF parameter. The chart can export to several other formats as well. For my short tutorial, I'll leave the JavaScript code on the same page. However, I recommend you place your JavaScript code into a separate file. In fact, this project template uses this best practice. For example, in the content folder, the gridview.js file handles all the client-side functionality for the gridview page. The gridview page references the external JS file and can call the functions within it. Let's run this in the browser. Now when I click export, the chart is displayed as a PDF. With the chart stretched to fit the page and the landscape layout, it looks great. And that's it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial on the DevExpress ASP.NET Chart Control. If you liked this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you have questions, please comment below. And please remember to subscribe to this channel for more great DevExpress training videos. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.